Ooh, it's been a long day. I was up at 5, worked for a good hour and a half, maybe only just 2 hours. I can't remember. Anyway, left, drove to Mount Nebo to a good friend's house, Chad Gray, who spotted me 4 pine trees and trucked the final load of some white pine home. Had a bunch of calls both to and from his place and dictated a report. So, yeah, windshield time. Plus a little bit of dictation and talking on the phone, trying to be efficient. Anyway, a little tired, a little peaked. Going to try and train a little bit. And so who knows what's going to happen. Coffee's a good thing, isn't it now? Keeping with my lunacy, that is a 49 inch, almost a 17 inch tulip poplar. Now I've had this in a bag wrapped up for about 2 years, and so it should be nice and awesome, I'm hoping. So you'll know on the first 4 hits, probably on the first hit, something jumps out, it's on. Straight up, that log first fade hits are great, at least on the front. In the back it was dry as shit, so I just said screw this. Plus I had that big knot in the front of it. I'm trying not to bend my good hardwood trainer, so I'm just gonna finish it off like I would normally. I'm about 3 minutes post beating my brains out for about 97-98 seconds, so this will be the end of it, following the same chip line. Tulip poplar, and it's not that good, so I'll see how much effort I can put into this one. Definitely need to get something softer for the next log.
pleased with how the old fatty got that one. That's a 42 inch tulip with a hardwood axe. And it wasn't soft.
Dumbass has got about an 11 and a half, almost a foot sycamore up there. It's dry, using a hardwood axe. I'm an idiot, but anyway, it's fun. Just getting comfortable on the board. Hopefully we'll get a new pole put up on Sunday. Gator's been in the shop, so I haven't been able to pull poles into the barn, so I'm gonna use my truck to get a pole close to the opening of the barn, and then use the pillow muscles to get it inside, and then I'll have someone help me put it up. Got a 38 inch white pine, softwood. Hopefully I don't get confused. I've got a softwood axe. It's one of my trainers. It's one I would use in a springboard if it was a bad log. So it's not a great axe, but it's a decent axe. This wood is dead. It's been dead for a while. It was down for over a year before I put it in a trash bag and stored it. So it's dry in parts. So there'll be a lot of pink in it. Don't know how it's gonna cut. I'm just gonna open up two and two. And then just let it happen, and then do the same in the back. So if I can cut it under 20, I think that will be a good cut for this dead pine. Dead pine doesn't react to the axe like fresh pine or something that's been taken care of. Okay, I know I fell off. This is wet as shit. Normally it's not like that, but this is what I'm looking at. Look at that. That's freaking gorgeous. 8 and 7. Holy shit, I've never done that. Not even when I was cutting my best. And this first hit did fuck all when I fell off the log. Got a 35 and a half, almost 36 inch white pine. So that underhand surprised me. Normally this wood would have been dead, or I thought it would have been dead. Like for example, this log I had in a trash bag. I had the trash bag up to the top, and then it was out of the bag. So the only part of it that was shielded from the sun is what I'm chopping. And so it's dead. However, that dead wood cut amazing. So Yeah. It's bigger than an 11. It's not quite a foot. Let's try something stupid. What the hell? You know, it might be good enough. I'm using a big 8x8 Brute Forge. And so, let's see what happens.
I didn't expect that. Cut it right off with that one up. I should have just went freaking driving it after the one up in the back. Holy crap. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. I'll take it.